Tiffany and all police say four men either planned or carried out this robbery that led to murder. One guy arrested today asked someone, did they know who he could rob? The second guy also arrested today said, yes, he knew of a target. And then the final two police say carried out the crime. But they didn't just take the flat screen TV, the PlayStation, the pot. Police say they also shot and killed the young mother who tried to stop them. Police say their investigation of Melanie Henningsen's shooting death led them to the first two suspects, Lamont Davis and Freddie McLawhorn. Police said Davis, nicknamed Killa, and McLawhorn, nicknamed Trouble, committed the burglary and murder in front of the victim's two-year-old son. As those two men sat in jail, police learned of a third man, Jose Vasquez, who, when questioned, admitted he knew the victim's boyfriend had marijuana in his house and had recently sold a vehicle and possibly also had cash.
He was the setup guy, both Vasquez has discussed the burglary to the resident because of the amount of marijuana and money and items being held in the house.
Police say Vasquez admitted he called the boyfriend, Jose Ortiz, and made a fake order for pot to make sure there was some in the house, then told a fourth man, Luis Soto, that Ortiz would be a good target to rob. That's when police say Davis and McLawhorn decided to carry out the crime.
Word got out on the street. And from the word getting out on the street, we know that Davis and McLawhorn were the two people responsible for entering into the house, committing this crime and shooting Ms. Henningsen.
Vasquez told police he did not know there was going to be a murder and apologized for the shooting. Police were able to track down the suspects because they used some unusual 10-millimeter ammunition. Police went to this gun shop and found an employee who remembered selling the 10-millimeter ammo to two men.
The 10-millimeter is an unusual caliber of ammunition. We believe it was purchased locally here in Port St. Lucie. I know there's video footage of it.
And police here say when they viewed that video, they recognized two of the suspects who already had criminal records. That led to their arrest, and then today, two more arrests. And they say when Vasquez came here to the police station, he still had marijuana in his pocket. Now, all four of them face first-degree murder charges. Two for conceiving and planning the idea and then possibly receiving some of the stolen goods, and two for actually carrying out the murder. Live in Port St. Lucie, Terry Parker, WPBF 25.